Hi everyone, welcome back to my Life 2D tutorial. Before we make the character move in Life 2D, we must prepare the illustration first. To animate an image with Life 2D, the image must be separated into several parts. In this tutorial, I will show you how to prepare your image for Life 2D purpose. In order to make any movement, we need to separate the illustration layer first. When we talk about separating the image, it doesn't mean to separate the line and color. It means to separating each body parts and accessories. The most common question from artists is, which parts would we need to separate? For example, let's look at figures and Figma. Figures have solid poses that you cannot change. But it's possible to change a Figma pose by moving their hand or tilting their heads. This is because Figma have joined in their body parts. In Life 2D, when we separate the right hand from the character body, we are really creating joints to allow the hand to move up and down. If we separate the forearm arm parts, now we can have added joints to make the forearm move, as well as the palm hand parts. The more parts you separated, more parts can be reached by the Life 2D artist. You can see an example of separated illustration on Life 2D official website. Downloads, sample data. Try separate each part to understand how it works. You can also see the parts more clearly on Texture Atlas. Let's try to separate a PNG type illustration. In this tutorial, I will just show a basic separated image for more detailed separation like face parts, hair parts, and body parts. I will explain it clearly in the next tutorial. When cutting part for your illustration, please make sure each part has different layer. Make a folder for every part that you are already separated. Setting a neat folder will help you to organize all the parts. This also helps the Life 2D designer to understand where the part is located on the model's body. We can start with dividing the head and the body. For body parts, I will divide it into two big parts, upper body and lower body. In the upper body, we will have the neck part, arm, and the body. I will divide the arm part into three parts: upper arm, forearm, and hands. Every part must have own layer. For lower body parts, I will divide them into the skirts and legs. The legs I will further I divide it into three parts: thigh, sang, and shoe. For head parts, I will divide them into the front and back hair, face, ear, nose, mouth, and eyes. I will explain how to divide the eye and mouth parts in detail in next video, so don't worry about it. Let's learn the basic cutting first. Our parts are already separated, but it's not ready for live 2D yet. We need to fill void first. You may ask, what is void? Well, you can see when I try to move the arm up on live 2D, you can see the body piece is detached from each other. It seems there is an incomplete part. To be able to make your image move freely in live 2D, void filling is needed. Back part or parts between joints will need to be filled in different ways and make sure there are no holes in each object. When we fill the void, I suggest to always follow the character shape and make it fit. Coloring like a rock draft is not a good idea. Some parts may need to redrawn because it's almost covered by front parts. Just because it is covered by front parts, it doesn't mean you don't need to fill. If your character moves, it may expose the back part that was not filled. Always draw the back part neatly so the animator can create the movement without constraint or hiding voids. You can also watch my previous video to learn how to fill voids for 3D objects. When we separate the illustration parts and fill the voids, we want it to show exactly like the PNG illustration. So that's why drawing order is important. The hand parts we put behind the upper body and lower body parts so it should look more natural. The back hair parts we put behind face parts. It is easier to fill void if the illustration have a simple or solid color. The voids are harder to fill if the illustration has a complex coloring, complicated texture, or if they have many accessories. Also, it is easier to fill the voids if the original artist handles the drawing, because each artist uses a different drawing application, different drawing style, and differing brush and technique. Additionally, it's easier to original artist to redraw hidden body parts because he knows the shape better. For example, the shape of face part mostly covered by hair. When you done cutting the parts, make sure PSD data is named and organized neatly. Create separate folder for the left and right parts. Don't forget to check out for pixel dirt. Make sure every part is clean. No dot or other body parts are mixed. Each illustration may need different ways of separation depending of the accessories and level of complexity of the movement. But this would be example of standard separation.